adultery. You just have to think about it. Pornography. Swimsuits. Thinking and looking in God's eye is an act of an adultery, and you will be charged guilty. Let's drop that down. You ever told a lie? One lie. Well, the Bible says that one of the commandments is, thou shalt not bear false witness. You blew it. And James writes in his epistle, if you offended one deed, you are guilty of. One lie makes you guilty of all 10 commandments. You are guilty before God. How are you going to pay for it? You ain't going to have your credit card. You ain't going to have George Washington, Ben Franklin. That ain't worth nothing. What? Gold? God made gold, Genesis 1. God made silver, Genesis 1. You going to pay God back with something that is his in the first place? Oh, I'm a good person, preacher. There is none good. There is none that doeth right. There is none righteous. No, not one. Bible rules you out as a good person. What are you going to do? How many good deeds does it take to cover up a lie? Where is the menu board? I go to McDonald's, I'll see how much a hamburger costs before I order it. What is the price of this? What if you miss a day? What if you sleep all day because you're sick and you couldn't pay that day? Uh-oh, you got credit. Bad credit. You got a debit. And there are sins in your life you don't even know what you're doing. There are sins in my life I don't even know what I'm doing. I got to go to God in prayer and ask Him. But the Bible says, 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful, God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. It said He, my friend. It didn't say she. Uh-oh, somebody's religion's wrong because it says He. That's interesting. Let's find out who that He is. Go to Timothy. Certain religions don't want you to open the Bible, my friend. Because if you do, you will explode. Let me just find a verse here. The Bible says in 1 Timothy 2:5, for there is one God. The Bible says it. I don't care if you're an atheist. What's that matter to God? You'll still stand before that God you don't believe in and have to give an account for you just because you say you don't believe in Him? Who do you think you are? All right. There is one God and one mediator between God and man. The man, not woman, the man, Christ Jesus. Well, we already read, if you put your sins under the blood, God will forgive and forget and wash. If you put your sins under anything but Jesus Christ, it will not be accepted. God will not wash away that sin. They will still stand. And they will stand to condemn you. Let's read on. Who, speaking about God and the Lord Jesus Christ, will have all men to be saved? God does not want to cast men into hell. He does not. But because of His holiness, and because you are not, because of His payment, and you reject it, because of your sins, God must cast you into hell by rejecting Jesus Christ. God has paid the payment. You just need to sign the dotted line. And oh, how the vast people just keep on going with life and pretend not to hear. They have eyes to see, but they see not. They have ears to hear, but they hear not. Let me tell you something, folks, something that you all know about. Well, pretty much all. I'll wait for the mufflers to go by. I don't know where Robin Williams is today. If he believed on the Lord Jesus Christ as his Savior, he's in heaven with Jesus today. If he refused Jesus and the gospel, he is burning in hell right now. But I'll tell you one thing I do know about Robin Williams. He is a Bible believer today. When he took his last breath, the Bible became true wherever he went. I hope he believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, but I don't know. I'm here to tell you that every graveyard in the world, from Adam and Eve to today, that funerals are happening right now, they are Bible believers. They know there is a God. They know there's a heaven. They know there is a hell. Let me read Luke 16. And from Luke 16 is a man that Jesus records is in hell. He is burning. He's being tormented. The Bible records he has a mouth, he has eyes, he can talk. He is being tormented in the flames forever. Do you know what that man in hell wants? Do you know what your family members want that are in hell today? I'll read you. In Luke 16, verse 27. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldst send him to my father's house. For I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. Do you know that there are people in hell who are amen in this preacher right now? There are people in hell that you know as family members, and they are pleading that you will listen to me, the Bible, that you do not go to hell with them. That means you do not party with your friends in hell. You are in torment in hell and in fire. Alcohol evaporates. Water evaporates. You are outside of God's mercy according to Luke 16, 27, 28. Those family members, those friends in hell want you to listen to me that you don't go there. Satan has made you to believe that hell is a party. How can you party in flames? How can you party outside of God's presence when the Bible says that God is love? Don't believe the lies. Believe the Bible. What I have been saying has been from the Bible. It's not what I think. It's not the traditions of men. It is the Holy Bible given to you by God, by the inspiration of the Holy Scriptures. Yeah, but men wrote it. That's another lie that Satan wants you to have as a cop-out. You're not going to know this word until you do the first obedience act. The first obedience act that God wants you to do is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. It It's nothing but the blood of Jesus, the hymn says. Amazing grace has saved a wretch like me. You're going to die one day. You will all die. I will die. Death is sure. Some people get out of paying taxes. But death is sure. I don't care who you are. And when you face that final breath, what is your hope? And I'll tell you what the Bible says about hope. Titus 2:13, it's Jesus Christ. Listen, I've talked to religious people out there. They don't have the assurance that the Bible gives. The Bible says these things are written on you that you may know. I know where I'm going to go when I die. I know it. What about you? I'm here to tell you Acts 16, verse 30 and 31. What must I do to be saved? The answer is simple. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. With your heart. With your mouth. Romans 10, 9 and 10. It is simple. And yet, many of you, the Bible says, will walk on to the ways of hell and will burn. And God is long-suffering. God is not willing that any perish. And you will go into those flames under your own accord. You will go into those flames because you choose to be dead to Jesus Christ. I stand here as a big stop sign in your life. Stop! Stop! And listen. Because stop, drop, and roll does not work in hell. Stop, get on your knees before the cross of Calvary. Repent of your sin will get you out of hell.